So the truth is, efforts to contain this thing have failed. That's not even an option on the table anymore. This thing is going to hit us, and it is going to hit us hard. The only thing we can hope to do now is just try to flatten the curve. So you've probably heard this phrase before, but many of you probably fully don't understand it. So today I'm gonna go over what flatten the curve means, how we can do it, and why at this point, that is our best course of action. So to really understand this phrase, we need to go back to 1918. This is when the Spanish flu pandemic was spreading across the world and just entered into the United States. Many cities took it seriously and other cities did not. So Philadelphia is one of the cities that did not take it seriously. And they made the decision to move forward with a parade to support the efforts of World War I. And over 200,000 Philadelphia residents gathered on the streets to celebrate this parade. Just 3 days later, every single hospital bed in Philadelphia's 31 hospitals was filled with patients dying of the Spanish flu. This single decision to move forward with this parade led to the deaths of thousands of residents, and Philadelphia saw a huge spike in the number of Spanish flu cases, and this completely overwhelmed their hospitals' capabilities. Overwhelming their hospitals is what led to the city having a higher mortality rate than other cities that did not see this big spike in cases. Now, at the same exact time, the city of St. Lucius took the opposite approach. After their very first case, they enforced a regulation closing down all schools, libraries, and churches, as well as any public gatherings of 20 people or more. Because of these measures, the city never saw that big spike in cases, and their hospitals were not overwhelmed by the sick. And this is ultimately what led to them seeing less than half per capita flu-related deaths than Philadelphia. And today we're seeing this exact same pattern emerge with countries that took immediate action and those countries that did not. Here you can see the number of infected cases in Italy, who was extremely unprepared for this and took actions way too late, versus the number of cases in South Korea, who watched this spread to their neighbor China very closely and took immediate action after their very first case. This is a very clear example of one country flattening the curve while another one did not. The truth is, the mortality rate of this virus in any given country is going to be heavily influenced by the limitations of their healthcare system. If the system gets overwhelmed, like we're seeing in Italy right now, the mortality rate of this virus is going to go up in that country. And it's not only an increased mortality rate for the patients with this virus, but increased mortality rate for all the other life-threatening conditions that the hospital typically treats, like cancer and diabetes. All hospitals have a limited number of doctors and nurses and resources, and if they're allocating them to patients sick with this virus, they're not gonna have as many resources for the other patients that are already in the hospitals. If countries can take actions now to prevent them from seeing a huge spike in the number of cases, so their hospitals are not overwhelmed, this will save lives. So this chart here demonstrates what the goal is of flattening the curve. The left represents the number of cases, and the bottom represents the time, and the dotted line represents the capability of our healthcare system. If we do nothing, we will overwhelm our healthcare system and see more deaths in our country. If we take actions now, we can flatten the curve and spread the number of cases out on a longer time frame and not overwhelm our hospitals. So how do we flatten the curve? Well, there's really two things that we can do. One is social distancing so that we're not spreading the virus as quickly. And the second one is better hygiene so that we are less likely to get infected and also less likely to infect others. So social distancing, this includes things like avoiding crowds altogether. So this means things like churches, restaurants, airports. Do whatever you can to avoid these crowded spaces. You also want to avoid traveling. If you do have the virus and you don't know it, by traveling, you could be bringing that virus to a whole new region that didn't have it before. In fact, it may not be a bad idea to just self-quarantine yourself in your own home and only go out if it is absolutely necessary. And this is what my family is personally doing, and we're now on our fourth day of self-quarantining ourselves. And then the other approach that we can take is better hygiene. And the most obvious example of this is washing your hands often. Believe it or not, soap is actually a really effective killer of this virus. This virus has an oily layer around it, and soap is very effective at disintegrating that layer. So make sure you use plenty of soap and make sure you wash your hands for 20 seconds straight. And we of course also want to avoid touching our faces as much as possible. I have never realized how much I touch my face until this outbreak started. And you also want to make sure that you cover your face when you cough or sneeze, either with a tissue, with a face mask, or inside your elbow. But don't cover your mouth with your hand, because then you're just going to get the virus on your hand, and you're not even going to think about it, and you're going to touch a doorknob or a handrail or something like that, and you could be spreading the virus that way. And of course, if you are sick, you definitely need to be self-quarantining yourself, even if you only have mild symptoms. This virus actually only shows mild symptoms to the majority of people that it does infect, but you can still spread this virus just as effectively as anybody else. If you want to see my video on what items I recommend that you do and do not stock up on, click right here to check that out. And don't forget to subscribe and hit that bell icon to get notified every time I upload a new video.